Okay, so this is Daredevil. 1/12 scale, 6 inches tall. This bit of string is attached with resin welded to another piece, which is about 6 mil long. That bit there. So this bit is actually three sections, because there's one bit there. That's quite there, and there's another section there. Now this is flexible ABS resin, so it shouldn't break, but at the joints it breaks. So there is a plan, and what we plan to do is we're going to cut off these pieces of cable, because I don't want breaks in them. Like that. Okay. So that's that problem solved. There was kinks in that one section. And what we're going to do is we're going to drill a little tiny hole in there and put in some of this cord, which is nice elastic. So when it attaches to Kingpin, it's nice and tight and forgiving, and it ain't going to break. Okay. Right, so I'm going to crack on with this, and there'll be some painting in a bit. So Kingpin is, flesh colour is drying. Well, he's drying. I'm putting some dark grey onto Daredevil. So we're going to use a big brush, bit of water. What the hell was that? No idea. Right, so dark grey, bit of water. Might need a bit more paint on it, but we're going to go over most of this. And pick out the red bits after. There's a lot of dust on there. Now it's very difficult to find out which parts of this suit is black and which is red. Okay, there's no easy way to say this. I messed up. It took me about a week to strip off the paint and rework it, and it's time to go again, so let's go again. Okay guys, as this is a Daredevil versus Kingpin build, it's time to work on Daredevil. I've reworked it, primered it, I didn't like the way I started painting it, so... Okay, so we're going to go first colour. Actually, first colour should be that colour. Because you need to get in the shadows. I think I'm going to go fast and loose with this. Get it everywhere, paint the whole thing. That is our colour. Rojo Necro Summit. No, Rojo Nocturno. Which is fitting. Use a big brush. A bit of water. I get the whole lot. Daredevil part 2, first highlights, which will be scarlet red. Okay, you're up with that. We get some tissue. Start from the back. So let's say we haven't done the flesh tone on this yet, because this is going to be so messy. I'll probably paint all over it. I'm going to finish this and I get back to you. Okay, and the last highlight we're doing on Daredevil is Carmine Red. I've got another game colour red, which is way, way too bright. So, got a bit on there. Tap it off on a bit of kitchen roll, and I just want to do downward strokes on the highest points. So there you go. That's all the highlights I'm going to do on this. Come to look at the shadows next. Once this is dried. No, I'll tell you what I'm doing now. There's some black patches on this. And we need to figure out where they are. Where to put them. Okay. I'm painting the black on a model. It's just black. And there is a area here. So I'm just going to paint in the line. There's one. We'll wait for that to dry. This one's a bit difficult because it's got the holder. Covering it. Right. Try it so carefully. Okay, legs are done. I'll carry on with the rest another time. This is Daredevil at the moment. He's, I've done the face. The face was brown rose with a little bit of, there you go, face was layer brown rose with a little bit of basic skin tone mixed to go on the highlights, and then we had a little wash with Agrax Earthshade, which was thinned down quite a bit with water, and we got something that looks fleshy. Yeah, that's quite good. Do the accessories, then the leather brown. I'll do the belt brown. And the brown I'm using is Game Color Charred Brown. It comes out quite thin, so there's no need to put water on into it. You can if you want to, but I like the consistency of it. note to self, it's my birthday next week, and I must get a new mount for my phone. Leave it to dry and get back to some Hilux in a minute. First, liver Hilux are a 50-50 mix of earth and charred brine. And we got this lovely, disgusting colour. So I'm going to just highlight the edges. As we do with a dry brush. Across the top of there and down, because you've got a recess. Across the top of there. Too much on that brush at that point. Oh, something tells me I'm hungry. Yes, I'm hungry. Too much on the brush. Okay, I'll leave that to dry. Second highlight is just plain earth colour. Got my small dry brush for this. That's a bit like that. Okay, next up, we're going to put in some shadows. I've painted the batons. There you go. I painted the batons black and then highlighted them. A bit of dry brush with some light blue, which we used on Kingpin. Kingpin's trousers, the base colour. So now I'm going to add some shadows. This is Black Lotus Express colour, which isn't black, it's blue. But it's a nice shadow colour. So as all shadows are purple, red and blue make purple, but we're going to be gentle. So we've got our neat express colour and we're going to dilute it quite a bit. As I said, express colour, Black Lotus is blue. And we need to go a bit thinner than that. Paint that. Okay. Here goes nothing. I'm going to start off with just putting it on the liver. Belt down here and across here, and it should sit nicely across there, quite nicely into the creases. You could do this in stages, let it dry, and carry on. Or you just go for it, the whole thing. At the moment, I'm actually wondering if I should just do it in stages. Leave it to dry. Because that bit worked well. Just need a little bit of a top up. Just a bit there. Across there. So as we're going to sit this in this position, let's see what this does. Okay, I'm going to let it sit for a little bit and see what happens and get back to it. I've kind of opted for washing half or the lower half of the model. So I'm going to let this sit and dry, and I'm going to go get some breakfast, and I'll come back in a bit. I thought I'd show you this at the halfway point. The bottom half I've done, the legs I've done, and they're drying. A little bit of shine to it, but I can dull that down with some varnish. The top half I haven't done yet, so there is a significant tone difference on there, and I like it. I've had this hanging up on my paint rack in that position. It was basically hanging like that, so all the express colour has been settling underneath, so everything underneath is dark, and it's exactly what I wanted. So next is to do the front. Or is it the back? If I do the front, I can leave it to hang till it's dry, and then I'll do the back. I think that's the plan. So same mix that we're using. It's been sat for a few minutes, but it's still good consistency. And just need to get the pinning in everywhere. To the shoulder pads. I don't think I want to go any further than that. And around the abs. That part there. Don't want to do the head yet. If you use a big brush, and this is my big brush, if we wet it and then take some wet out, we can take off some of the express colour. Pop a few bubbles. This to sit for a little bit and come back, and I've got shapes. And come back. It's looking good. It is looking good. Yes, there's illness around. I just want to lift up here. Okay. Hopefully his head will get into all the creases. I don't want it to go into the flesh color if I can help it. Already put a wash on the flesh tone. That's a bit of that, isn't there? Just want a little bit of light across there. And still put shadow in there. And that is one big blob, and I don't want it. Okay, I'm leaving this one for now, and I'll get back to you later. Cheers, guys. Okay, this is the next day, and the wash is dried. And it looks like this. I'm very happy with it. And I'm going to put a bit of varnish on it next. Okay, Daredevil's planted literally into the face of Kingpin. He's glued in place. Got a couple of small holes. Ooh, hang on. I got a couple of small holes in the top there. We've got some elastic which we can put into there. Like that, and have that. I mean, doesn't it? That works. Screw it. Right. So that works. There's no kinks in it, like with the 3D printed free section part. So that's that bit there. What we got next to do? It was varnished with Ultramatte by MIG, and I didn't like it. It was all chalky and disgusting. So a bit of Vallejo matte acrylic varnish. It's got this nice leathery kind of touch to it. Everything else had the same. I got a few touches, got some glass down here, which got to put some colour on. And put it all together with the stained glass on the back. I need a new phone holder. All right. On to the next section. Thanks, guys. Like, comment, subscribe if you can. Be appreciated. I'm getting to near 1,000 followers now, so that would be really good achievement. Cheers, guys.